Great teams win championships. Players exercise together for hours. They win some games. They lose others. At the end, they work to win the biggest award, which is a championship. The same is true for political players. 2 years ago, Lemma Megersa and ABIY started a new political journey in Ethiopia. They spoke of unity. They spoke of love. They spoke of Ethiopian nationalism as a form of addiction. Together, they were able to defeat the Tigrayan People's Liberation Front or TPLF, a powerful entity based in the northern region of Ethiopia. ABIY went on to be the Prime Minister of Ethiopia. He was tasked by the Oromos and other Ethiopians to oversee the transition to a brighter Ethiopia where democracy and rule of law will take precedence. Lemma was removed from his post as President of Regional Oromia Government. He was moved to the position of Ethiopian Defense Minister, a less powerful position. Since then, Lemma, who is loved by the Oromo people and who was trusted by Oromo activists, has been absent from center stage of Ethiopian politics. There have been rumors behind the scenes that Lemma has been under house arrest for the last few months. Yet this is not verified. Most recently, Ethiopia witnessed the political assassination of the iconic Oromo singer, Hachalu Hundesa. This marked a watershed moment for Oromos who have been fighting for their right for over a century. Since then, there has been riots and property damage in Ethiopia. Close to 300 people have also lost their lives over the course of the last month. Today's announcement by the Prosperity Party regarding the purging of Lemma is a bit surprising. 2 years ago, Lemma famously gave up his position of the Oromo People's Democratic Organization or OPDO leadership so that ABIY can ascend to the position of the Prime Minister of Ethiopia. So, Lemma was a great confidant of Prime Minister ABIY. That is why today's announcement appears shocking to many. At a time when many Oromos who struggled to bring ABIY to power have become political prisoners themselves, it is hard to see how the dismissal of Obo Lemma or his colleagues can serve the interest of the Oromos or Ethiopia. The country already faces numerous challenges, including inflation. The COVID-19 pandemic has taken a toll on many. There is also lack of legitimacy as groups like the Oromos do not trust the intention of the current Ethiopian government. Is Ethiopia heading toward a one-party state? Evidences so far suggests the theory that the ABIY government is consolidating power into a single-party system. It is hard to see how this could be good for the democratization of Ethiopia. Dialogue, consensus building, negotiation and honesty are still needed to make peace and govern responsibly. More importantly, ABIY promised to hold fair and free election in a timely fashion. Yet, the postponement of the national election raises serious questions than answers. Powerful states and governments in Ethiopia have come and gone. It is time the government engages people based on genuine effort. It is hard to imagine what the future holds for the famous politician, Lemma Megersa. But it is clear from recent government actions that dialogue is not part of the equation when it comes to solving conflicts. We hope cooler heads will prevail. Thank you for watching. Continue to support Harar Star. Subscribe to our channel.